Our other top story, a stranger tells a girl, let's go for a ride.
She didn't go, and she's safe. But it took a day before police came to take her statement. KMBC 9's Dan Weinbaum joins us live to explain why. Dan?
Well, the girl was smart enough to know better than to go with that man yesterday. Now, apparently there was some kind of miscommunication somewhere along the line that kept police here from talking to that girl until today.
Tuesday afternoon, and Shawnie Ferguson had stepped off a Metro bus coming home from school.
And I was walking down the street from the Troost playground, and this blue car rolled by me with this man in it. He waved at me.
Shawnie didn't wave back and kept walking.
He backed up and said, it's a nice day outside. Why don't you get in? I'll take you home. And I was like, no, I'm cool.
Real cool, but shaken. She ignored the man she did not know.
Maybe he's a pervert. I don't know.
Once inside her home, Shawnie called her mom at work.
So I called the police. I did a 911 call to the police when she told me what happened.
Police responded. They looked around for the man, and that was it. They did not take a police report. Officers were told to not contact the family.
That's what was in the computer, that the citizen did not wish to be contacted.
Oh. The police officers informed me that they had a no contact on the sheet that was done, which I never said, do not contact me. She never asked for a number or anything.
But if she says differently, then we'll have to look and see if there was a breakdown, and if so, where it occurred. Okay.
But you are on top of it now.
We're on top of it.
It's true. Officers came to take a statement today, and the neighborhood crawled with patrol cars and tactical officers looking for that stranger.
Well, the description that was given to police, a blue older type of car, like a sedan, maybe like an Oldsmobile with a dented driver's door, a black man in his 50s or 60s, salt and pepper hair with a slender bill. Police are, of course, looking for him, and they're looking into the issue of the contact, no contact. They're investigating that as well. We're live at Metro Patrol. Back to you.
All right, Dan, thank you. Well, here's some information you should know according to Kansas Police Major Randall Hundley. If you call 911, that's not all you have to do to make sure an investigation into a crime begins. You should ask to be contacted. Then a report can be made and passed along up the chain to detectives. If you do not wish to be contacted, police will respond, but if they find nothing, they'll move on.